Polynomials and factoring. A polynomial is a monomial or a sum of monomials. The following polynomial is the sum of the monomials 3x to the fourth, 5x squared, negative 7x, and 1. So here's the polynomial 3x to the fourth plus 5x squared minus 7x plus 1. When we're talking about polynomials, we can refer to the degree of each monomial, or its exponent. So 3x to the fourth is the degree of 4. 5x squared is to the degree of 2. Negative 7x is to the degree of 1, and 1 is to the degree of 0. So the degree is the exponent of the variable. Here we have the constant 1, which is really 1 times x to the 0 power. The polynomial shown above is in standard form. Standard form of a polynomial means that the degrees of its monomial terms decrease from left to right. The degree of a polynomial in one variable is the same as the degree of the monomial with the greatest exponent. So in our example, since 4 is the largest exponent, the degree of that polynomial is 4. You can name a polynomial based on its degree and/or the number of monomials it contains. So here we have the polynomial 6, just the number 6. It has a degree of 0. We can call that a constant. The number of terms is just 1, so it's a monomial. 5x plus 9, that has a degree of 1, x to the first power. It's linear. It has two terms, so we call it a binomial. 4x squared plus 7x plus 3 has a degree of 2. Degree of 2 or squared is called quadratic. It comes from the word quadrus, meaning square, but we call it quadratic. Number of terms is 3, so we would call it a trinomial. 2x to the third has a degree of 3, so it's a cubic. There's only one term, so it's a monomial. 8x to the fourth minus 2x to the third plus 3x. The degree is to the fourth power. That's a quartic. And the number of terms we have is 3, so it's a quartic trinomial. And anytime we have four or more terms, we call it just a polynomial. So we can name each polynomial by the degree and by the number of terms. So here's our first example. Name each polynomial by degree and number of terms. Rewrite in standard form. Negative 2n plus 9n squared plus 2n to the third. So to rewrite this in standard form, I'm going to take the highest exponent and go from greatest to least. So in standard form, this polynomial is 2n to the third plus 9n squared minus 2n. The highest degree or exponent is 3. That's cubic, and there's three terms, so this is a cubic trinomial. Go ahead and try number 2. Negative 3m to the third minus 10m to the fourth. Rewriting this in standard form, negative 10m to the fourth minus 3m to the third. It's to the fourth power, so it's a quartic, and there's two terms, so it's a binomial. Go ahead and try number 3. And number 4. All right, so now that we've written in standard form, we're going to now add and subtract polynomials. So here we have two polynomials added together. And the grouping here is just to say that all these terms go together and all these terms go together. So we have two different trinomials we're adding together. So adding polynomials is very simple. We just combine like terms. So this is written horizontally. I'm going to write it vertically so I can add them easier. So I'm going to just place all these with the corresponding term. So x squared, so that's really plus 1x squared. Then I have a minus 7x to the third and a minus 3x. Now I just combine like terms and I'm adding them. So I have a negative 5x to the third plus 9x squared minus x. So go ahead and try number 6. Right, now we're going to subtract. So when we subtract, we're going to take this trinomial minus 5 minus a negative 7p to the fourth minus a negative 8p to the third. So sometimes it can be a little tricky and we can get our signs mixed up when we subtract. But if we rewrite this as a addition problem, then we won't have any problems with our signs. So we're just going to rewrite the signs. So instead of minus a positive 5, we're going to say plus a negative. Minus a negative is plus a 7. Minus a negative is plus an 8. So now I'm just going to rewrite this as an addition problem. So the 5s go together, so that's a minus 5. And a plus p to the 4, 7p to the 4. And a plus 8p to the third. So 13p to the 4 plus 13p to the 3 plus 2. So the best thing to do when you are subtracting polynomials is to rewrite it as an addition problem and then add them. So go ahead and try number 8. Number 9. Now we're going to multiply some polynomials. We're going to multiply a monomial, a single term, times a binomial, a polynomial with two terms. And we're just going to use the distributive property. So we're going to multiply the coefficients first. Negative 4 times negative 4 is a positive 16. And now we're going to multiply the variables. We're multiplying the bases, so we add the exponents. So this is n to the third. The next term, we're just going to multiply the coefficients here of a negative 4 and a negative 2 is a plus 8, and then we have an n squared. So go ahead and try number 10. Number 11, we're going to multiply a monomial, a single term, times a trinomial, three terms, again using the distributive property. Negative 8 times a negative 1 is a positive 8, and then we have a k squared. Negative 8 times a positive 6 is a negative 48, and we have a k. Negative 8 times a positive 2 is a negative 16. Go ahead and try number 12. Now we're going to find the greatest common factor. We're going to factor these polynomials. We're going to undo the distributive property. When we're factoring, we want to end up with the first term, a positive number. All right, so we have negative 24 and 8. So we're going to look at 8 and 24. What's the greatest common factor is an 8. So we're going to factor out a negative 8, v squared, and v to the fourth. What's the biggest number that will divide evenly into both of them? And that is going to always be the variable with the smallest exponent, because it'll go into itself and it'll go into the bigger exponent. So we're going to factor out a v squared. Let's just say 2 here. Right, and that leaves us then, if we factored out, we had a negative 24, and we factored out a negative 8, negative 24 divided by negative 8 is a positive 3. And then v squared divided by v squared is just 1. Then we have an 8, and we factored out a negative 8, so that's going to give us a negative 1. V squared, and we factored out a v to the fourth, and we factored out a v squared, will give us v squared. So go ahead and try number 14. Try 15. Sixteen. Seventeen. And 18.